Welcome to AASHA's IAS Institute. This is our website www.aasha.com. Here in the current affairs section, we upload daily current affairs as such, and also monthly compilations are available here. Presently in this video, we are going to discuss current affairs keywords for prelims 2019. So we have prepared a list of keywords for various topics which will be gradually added up in these columns. So presently for culture and history and for social too, in schemes, schemes would be the next which would be added. So culture and history, we can see. So we have already started off. The first lecture in this series was done. So in that we have discussed April 2018 keywords from culture and history, means current affairs keywords for the month of April, last April. So now we are going to the month of May. You can save this image too. So you can open the image in a new tab too. So here we have this image. So in this saved image, you can see for the month of May, the important keywords are mentioned here. So this you can also get further detail. If this much is not sufficient, you can get full detail for the month of May from the May compilation. So that is available on the website. You can see the month-wise compilations are available here. You can download them. So here I have the May compilation with me, full news compilation, and in this history and culture part will be covered right now. So going to page number 9. So here we have the first keyword also. If you have a look at it, it is Aligarh Muslim University. So you should know about Aligarh Muslim University, AMU. It was established as a college, Mohammedan Anglo Oriental College, in 1875 by Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. So he was a Muslim social reformer, which you should study in history, and you must have studied in history. So presently AMU is in news because it claims to be a minority institute, while Allahabad High Court recently struck down its minority status, that it does not have any minority status, is what the Allahabad High Court ruled. And also in the same context, Muhammad Ali Jinnah's portrait in AMU was an issue too. That his portrait is hung in Aligarh Muslim University. So Muhammad Ali Jinnah was the founder member of AMU in 1875 at that time as such, when the institute was established. So his portrait is stuck there. Not in 1875, because Aligarh Muslim University, the college became a university later. So as a founder member, he was there. So Muhammad Ali Jinnah, he was the one who was responsible for partition, and he established a separate nation, Pakistan. That is later history. But Aligarh Muslim University history has Jinnah as its founding member. So this has become an issue. This was made into an issue rather. So Muhammad Ali Jinnah was in news. We'll see both of them in detail over here too. You can see. So this was a BJP member of parliament who asked AMU to explain why it displays a portrait of Muhammad Ali Jinnah. So this is after a student sought permission to hold an RSS shakha on its premises. So RSS shakha is proposed to be established in Aligarh Muslim University, and when the when objection came on this, the BJP MP attacked AMU on this Pakistan founder's picture on the wall of AMU students union office. So that is the case. So you should know about both AMU also. The entire detail is provided here. You can see it was established as Mohammedan Anglo Oriental College, and it was designed to train Muslims for government services in India. And later it became a Aligarh Muslim University in 1920. So in 1920, Muhammad Ali Jinnah was the founder member. So its main campus is in Aligarh. It also has two functioning off-campus centers. That is, presently it has these two off-campus centers in Malappuram and Murshidabad. And this is regarding Muhammad Ali Jinnah. He actually was a member of Indian National Congress. So in early years, Muhammad Ali Jinnah advocated Hindu-Muslim University. Even he helped shape the Lucknow Pact between Congress and All India Muslim League in 1916. He also was a key leader in the All India Home Rule League movement, which was also spearheaded by Annie Besant. So he worked with her. In 1920, Jinnah resigned from Congress. So he did not agree with Mahatma Gandhi's campaign of Satyagraha. So when Mahatma Gandhi came into picture, Jinnah resigned from Congress. And this is when he started his demands gradually for Muslims, taking up that plank and eventually getting a separate nation called Pakistan. Even he became the first Governor General of Pakistan until his death. He is revered in Pakistan as Qaid-e-Azam and Baba-e-Qaum. So that is the second point which is in news. The third point, the third keyword in news is Rabindranath Tagore. So you should know two things about Rabindranath Tagore. One, he renounced knighthood. He was awarded knighthood. Knighthood is the title of Sir. So he was awarded knighthood by the British government. But then when the Jallianwala Bagh massacre took place in 1919, he renounced his knighthood. And second, you should know that he won Nobel Prize. He won Nobel Prize in literature in 1913. That was even before the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. So he had written this anthology of poems, Gitanjali, which has been appreciated worldwide. So this is two. These are two main things. It was in news. We'll see, because of a statement which was made by this Tripura CM, who is famous for making such bluffs. His name is Biplab Deb. So he actually said that poet Rabindranath Tagore returned his Nobel Prize in protest against the atrocities committed by the British. It was not the Nobel Prize, though it was won in 1913. But in 1919, post the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, Rabindranath Tagore renounced his knighthood, because knighthood is conferred by the British government. Nobel Prize is international prize conferred by the Nobel organization. We know that. But this was the fact. So it's a Norwegian Nobel Prize which is conferred. So he renounced his knighthood. So that was the point. Earlier too, it is stated he has made statements that internets and satellites existed in the Mahabharata era. It's one of his statements. He also said that Diana Haydon was not worthy of the Miss World Beauty Pageant title. So because of her dark complexion or something. So that triggered a row. So he has made such blunders. So you should know about Rabindranath Tagore. He won the Nobel Prize of Literature in 1913. And he was a modernist. He believed in benevolent paternalism. So he actually, you know, was understanding the benefits of the British ruling the country. He wanted reforms, you know, in the Hindu religion as such. But post the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, he renounced his knighthood as well. He was, you know, his father was a leading proponent of Brahmo Samaj. Then in culture, again, we have Adopt a Heritage Scheme in news. So it was in news last month. We saw, because Dalmia Bharat group adopted the Red Fort in New Delhi. So this triggered protests. In Assam also, there are four sites that have been chosen to be handed over to corporate sector as part of this Adopt a Heritage Scheme. So there are protests, you know, of this scheme being put in Assam. So these four sites are mentioned here. You can see Kaziranga National Park, Rangghar, Karenghar and Shivadol. So Kaziranga National Park, you should know, is a national park which is famous for its one-horned rhinos. Rangghar is Asia's oldest amphitheater, so like an open theater. And Karenghar is a palace. Shivadol is a temple. All are in Shivasagar district of Assam. So here the detail regarding Shivasagar is also given. It was a seat of the Ahom kingdom for more than 600 years till finally British took over Assam. It is home to many historical monuments, which we just saw, like the Rangghar, etc., Karenghar, etc. So in the keywords also, you can see after Rabindranath Tagore, what we have next is Kaziranga National Park of Assam. So you should know it is known for its one-horned rhinos. Also Rangghar in Shivasagar, Assam, it's Asia's oldest amphitheater. So when the term phrase comes, Rangghar, when this keyword comes, you should be able to recollect what is it about. So these are the keywords listed here. That is there. Then below you have puppetry hangs by a thread in Prakasam. So this is again, now the key word is Tholu Bommalatta. So Tholu Bommalatta is actually shadow puppetry of Andhra Pradesh. So this shadow puppetry, you can see how it is done, is shown in the news. So this is practiced by certain families. It's an old art of shadow puppetry. Some families in Andhra Pradesh follow this. And so here you can see Tholu Bommalatta. Tholu Bommalatta literally means the dance of leather puppets. Tholu means leather. And Bommalatta means puppet dance. So this is an ancient custom. So it provides knowledge of Hindu epics. because it performs Hindu epics and local folk tales, and also it provides knowledge about news as such too, which is also portrayed in these shadow puppetry. The puppeteers make up some of the various entertainers who perform all night and usually reenact various stories from Hindu epics such as Ramayana and Mahabharata. So it takes place all night too. So this is Tholugammalatta, the shadow puppetry. Then next is Aranmula Valamkali. So this is actually what we understand as the boat race of Kerala. So that snake boats which are used in this boat race. So this boat race is called Aranmula Valamkali. So you should understand that. You can see it was in news here. So here you can see. So this is Tholugammalatta. You can see shadow puppetry, how it is done. So the image is there and there's a person in shadow behind. So it looks like the image performing. You can see the audience on the other side of the curtain. So this is shadow puppetry. Then this you can see is the origin of this leather puppetry Tholugammalatta mentioned here. This is Aranmula snake boat race of Kerala. So these snake boats, they are, you must have seen them, highly crested boats. These are the snake boats. There's this boat race which is held. So they are meant to be pedaled in tune with a rhythmic vanchipattu. So these are verses in praise of Lord Krishna. So these are being in rhythmically sung and the paddling is done. So that is also there. And the dress code for the oarsmen is dhoti and shawl. Then next is Rajaraja Chola concert idols recovered from Gujarat. So this is regarding idols recovered. So, and this is regarding chow. So the chow, you should know there are three types of chow. So it's actually a traditional art, folk art. So here you can see it has three types, that is Purulia, Seraikeli and Mayurbhanj. Purulia is from West Bengal, Saraikela from Jharkhand and Mayurbhanj is from Odisha. So there are three types of chow. All of them have been given geographical indication tag. So a GI tag actually connects the quality and authenticity of a given product to a particular geographical origin. So if it is from a particular geographical origin, it will have this certain quality and authenticity is conferred by this GI tag, which is announced. So this was announced by the Geographical Indication Registry and Intellectual Property India. So these five rural crafts have been given GI tags. One of them is chow mask. So in this chow performance, masks are worn. So these are built. So the masks made in Purulia, I have actually been given GI tag. Then wooden masks of Kushmandi. So that has the second one. Patachitra, Dokras of Bengal and Madhurkati, all have been given GI tag. So you should understand what are these two. First of all, you can see it's mentioned here regarding chow. Chow has three styles. So Purulia, Seraikela and Mayurbhanj. So Purulia, as the name suggests, is from Bengal, Seraikela from Jharkhand and Mayurbhanj from Odisha. So masks form an integral part of chow dance, especially in Purulia and Seraikela. So that is being mentioned here. And below here you have the chow mask shown too. And this is next, the wooden masks which are made. So these wooden masks made, you can see, is mentioned here. In wooden mask of Kushmandi. So if these are wooden masks from Kushmandi, they will have specific quality. So that is assured through GI tag. So associating any product with any geographical region. And this is Patachitra. So Patachitra is also actually from Orisha. So these are drawings on cloth, you can see. It originated in 8th century AD and is linked to the Jagannath temple of Puri in Orisha. So in earlier days, the chitrakars or painters were temple functionaries who lived in and around the temple town. And they mainly painted stories from Hindu epics, mythology, religious texts, etc. So you can see the colors are made from stones and plants. So these are natural colors used. Patachitra of Orisha. It's painting. It's a form of painting. Patachitra, and this is Dokra craft of Bengal. So how artifacts have been manufactured. So this is one of them, Dokras. And this is Madhur Kathipur, the mat. So we'll look at the keywords once again, what has been given, GI tag. Kaziranga National Park and Rangar were in use for being coming under the Adopt a Heritage Scheme. Both are in Assam. There are two others, but we picked up these two important ones. Thulubomalata, Shadow Puppetry from Andhra Pradesh. Aranmula Vallamkali, we discussed. Chau has been given GI tag. Patachitra, painting of Orisha, from Orisha rather, has been given GI tag. It's also found in West Bengal. It is done on cloth as we discussed. So, and second is Madhur Kathi. So Madhur Kathi is an art from West Bengal. Mats are made of soft reed. So it has also been given GI tag. And Dokra from West Bengal again. So this has been given GI tag too. This is actually non-ferrous metal casting which is done using lost wax technique. So you should know about this lost wax technique too. This is actually a technique which is used to build a model. So for example, you need a particular mold. So in that mold, initially you can see it can be formed. It is a wax model which is developed, and then on that wax model, a mold is placed in such a way that that mold gets the shape, like, you know, clay or so. So it gets the shape of the wax, and then it solidifies. So mold solidifies and wax is within it, and later wax is removed from it. So wax easily melts and it is removed from this mold. So wax is out and you've got the metal casting. So this is non-ferrous metal casting which is used. So this has been given GI tag, Dokra from West Bengal. So these are the important keywords from culture and history for May 2018. In next video, we'll look at important keywords for June 2018. So that is it. Thank you.